one of the big issues that we face here is this tension between focus and vision, right? Because Johannes talked about three different tracks. Would that it were only three, because you've got the reality of climate change and all the issues that we are going to deal with there. We've got a whole series of issues on nuclear security and thinking ahead to the NPT review conference that's going to take place next year, but those negotiations have already started and are fundamentally on the table with what's happening with Iran, how we deal with Russia and a new arms control agenda with Russia and how those play into this scenario, plus the huge surge in demand for civilian nuclear power, so how you deal with those sets of questions on that side. There are issues of transnational terrorism and how one effectively deals with those questions that fundamentally are transnational in nature but require domestic action. There are the whole set of issues that we're facing on Afghanistan and Pakistan, which play into the transnational terrorism agenda but are even broader than that. We come back to the whole question of protectionism, I think, because that's an issue I hope we come back and have more discussion about. Because we've talked about the importance of taking a stance against protectionism, but none of us have really talked about yet what really does happen to resuscitate the Doha round or actually do something that gives some credibility to the pledges that this group has been talking about. There are issues more broadly about transnational conflict and how we build the capacity to deal with conflict issues internationally. And so all of these issues are out there, right? And these leaders are basically facing a set of questions which on the economic crisis point out the fact that when we get into issues economically, financially, that cross borders, it is extremely difficult to regulate and deal with those problems. And we have exactly the same kinds of symptoms on each of those other issues as well.